I cannot express to you how upset I am right now at this announcement, this crazy, ridiculous announcement that Lane Snapper is closing. It is heinous that Lane Snapper are being announced to close. Please watch this video, share it with everybody and anybody who will listen, because it's wrong. It's wrong. So here's the facts surrounding Lane Snapper. In September 17th and 18th of 2019, the Science and Statistical Committee for the Gulf of Mexico Fishery Management Council had a meeting in which they reviewed an update to an assessment for Lane Snapper that showed an extremely healthy and vibrant fishery based on mandatory electronic reporting in the headboat sector. So headboats have to report their catch daily. They have been since like the 80s. Now it's electronic and we've been doing it forever. They use that data to prove Lane Snapper are so healthy. The Science and Statistical Committee for the Gulf of Mexico Fishery Management Council voted to increase the OFL, or overfishing limit, and ABC, or allowable biological catch, for Lane Snapper by more than double, because it's such a healthy fishery. October 2nd, 2019, the Reef Fish AP reviewed the SSC recommendation and voted to move it forward to the Gulf of Mexico Fishery Management Council. Fast forward, October 21st and 24th of 2019, the Gulf of Mexico Fishery Management Council had a meeting in which they got a bunch of other pressing issues. They didn't have a chance to get to the Lane Snapper document. Cool. Not a real big issue. We'll push it into January. January 2020. It's September 2021. Just so you know, folks, in January 2020, the Gulf of Mexico Fishery Management Council reviewed the SSC recommendations and the Reef Fish AP recommendations, and they voted to increase catch levels for Lane Snapper, preferred alternative 2, which would increase the ACL for Lane Snapper to over 570,000 pounds. It's currently sitting at 301,000 pounds, almost doubled the annual catch limit, or ACL, for Lane Snapper in this document. Now, in order for that document to go final and be transmitted to NOAA agency for final rulemaking, they can't do that unless they notice the meeting with 30 days notice. So they decided in January 2020 to make that document final at their April 2020 meeting. Well, fast forward April 2020, we all know the world went to hell in a handbasket, and that meeting was canceled due to COVID. Fast forward again, January 2021. It's September 2021. January 2021, guess what the council did? They finally got around to that Lane Snapper document again, and they voted to finalize preferred alternative 2, which would move the Lane Snapper ACL from 301,000 pounds to 579,000 pounds. Guess what? It took until March of 2021 to transmit that document to the agency for rulemaking. March 2021. It's almost October 2021, and that document still is not a rule. So now the agency is announcing a Lane Snapper closure in a healthy, vibrant fishery that in September of 2019, their Science and Statistical Committee said it was. And we've only caught 199,000 pounds of Lane Snapper, according to the NOAA website. So NOAA's website, the ACL monitoring page, shows how many fish we've landed so far. They've estimated we've landed 199,000 pounds of our 301,000 pound quota, less than two-thirds. And you're going to announce a closure in an extremely healthy fishery where the ACL should be almost double? But instead of instituting a rule that the council voted on in January 2020, transmitted March 2021, voted on January 2021, excuse me, transmitted March 2021, it's almost October 2021. And instead of instituting that rule that was transmitted and is sitting on someone's desk at NOAA Fisheries, close the fishery. Cool. Cool story. So read this post. I have all the links in there, all the notations. This is facts, guys. This is the timeline of how the fishery is getting screwed because someone dropped the ball. Period. Point blank, period. Someone dropped the ball. So let's find out who it was. Let's repeal that closure announcement. And let's not announce closures at 5 o'clock in the afternoon when you can't answer your phone to speak to the absolute ridiculousness that is in this closure announcement. That's all, folks. Share this with everybody who will listen. Let's get them to turn this around and institute the rule that was transmitted March 2021, that was voted January 2021. If you're too busy to go fishing, you're just too darn busy. But apparently, they don't want us fishing. Just close healthy fisheries. That makes a lot of sense.